where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day. Someone waits for me.
This is Ken Carpenter welcoming you to Philco Radio Time, produced and transcribed in Hollywood with John Scott Trotter, his orchestra and chorus, Skitch Henderson, and Bing's guests, William Frawley, Leo McCarey, and the lovely Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer star, Judy Garland. And here's Bing Crosby himself.
Oh, I'm not myself tonight, Ken, with Leo McCarey, Bill Frawley, and Judy Garland coming. I'm in a dither.
Oh, now, don't get excited, Bing. Aunt Judy is here to hold your hand.
Glad to see you, Judy.
Say, Bing, before I forget it, I want to congratulate you on that lovely color picture of you on the cover of March Photoplay magazine. You look like the man of distinction without a glass in your hand.
I thought it was rather an attractive pastel. I wonder who posed for it.
And your life story in Photoplay is so interesting and thrilling.
Did you read it?
Mm-hmm.
They didn't mention the fact there, did they, that I still owe Paul Whiteman $46?
No, I don't believe that's in the story.
Good, I won't have to pay him then. Anyhow, Judith, I'm happy you're here, and I wonder if it wouldn't be a good idea for us to blend our voices in a little tune titled Connecticut, sort of say hello to the folks there.
Good heavens, does this program go all the way to Connecticut?
Well, if we holler real loud, they're going to hear us in Hartford,
all
I
right.
promise you.
I know a spot, peaceful and fair. I'd be so happy if I were there, no matter where I chance to be. Connecticut is the place for me.
Miss every lake, miss every hill, even in dreams I think of them still. And when you see them, you'll agree. Connecticut is the place to be.
Village green, childhood scenes are things that I remember, yes.
Land of dreams and moonlit streams, how close to heaven can you get?
Nights full of stars, hearts full of joy.
Paradise for a girl and a boy.
I guess it suits me to a T. Connecticut is the place for me to be.
Connecticut is the place for me.
It's such a great state for a late date with a mate just waiting for you.
And every Yale guy is a male guy through and through.
That's in New Haven.
It's never humdrum dating some charm with a thumb strum and a guitar.
You'll find the chicks slicker and they mix much quicker by far.
Sounds like a great thing.
It's spick and spanner than old Montana and Indiana camp rate. Made it.
The nights are longer, yeah. The men are stronger. So
be.
Linger longer and wait. Cause it's a great, 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 great state. Dined in Capri, thought it was swell. Sampled some wine in a Naples hotel. Though I was showed the road to Rome, Connecticut still will be my home. Italy was fun to see and really gave me quite a boost.
Had a spree in gay Paris. Those mademoiselles were mighty cute. Très zoo. I circled the globe.
Circled the globe.
Of time. Seen all its wonders.
Seen all its wonders.
Known all its glories. I searched it with a fine-tooth comb. And found that I only have one home, sweet home. Connecticut always will be my home.
Eddie there, Union.
Hey,
Union's
Judy.
Union's gay tonight,
hey,
isn't it?
Great, yeah. I'll bet the people in Connecticut will be thrilled to hear that song.
Why, because they live in Connecticut?
Because they have Philco Radio.
You sneak.
Well, Bing, no matter where people live, they're happy just to have a Philco Radio.
Oh, I suppose then if somebody had a Philco Radio and no house to live in, they'd be happy?
Good girl, Judy.
Why, yes, Miss Garland, I'm sure they would.
I know a fellow who has a great big Philco console and no house, and he definitely is not happy.
Why not?
No shower bath.
Certainly, what's the fun of living in a radio that doesn't have a bath?
Well, let's take it up with Philco. I wouldn't be surprised if they came out with a combination radio, phonograph, and shower bath.
Oh, you're just out of your mind, can't you?
Of course I am, Bing. Everybody's out of their minds about those new Philcos. The 1201, for instance, there's a brand new Philco invention. The easiest radio phonograph in the world to spin records on. Just slide your record in and it plays automatically. Why wait for a radio with a shower bath when you can get a sensational deal like that? Ask your Philco dealer tomorrow for the 1201, the newest invention in radio from Philco, the leader.
Switching from the 1201, we turn blithely and lithely to the 303, Rosabelle McGhee. I got a girl that's mighty sweet, with big blue eyes and tiny feet. Her name is Rosabelle McGhee. She tips the scale at 303, oh gee. But ain't it grand to have a gal so big and fat that when you go to hug her, you don't know where you're at? You have to take a piece of chalk in your hand. You hug a ways and chalk a mark to see where you began. One day I was a huggin' and a chalkin', and a chalkin' and a huggin' away. When I met another fella with some chalk in his hand, coming around the other way, he was using radar. Coming around the other way. Nobody ever said that I'm weak. My bones don't ache and my joints don't creak. Listen at him. But I grow absolutely limp every time I kiss my blimp, oh gee. But ain't it grand to have a gal so big and fat that when you go to hug her, you don't know where you're at? You have to take a piece of chalk in your hand. You hug a ways and chalk a mark to see where you began. One time when I was hugging and a chalking and a begging her to be my bride, well, I met another fella with some chalk in his hand. Coming around the other side, it was the Hooper survey. Coming around the other side.
Nice, Bing, but I'm a little worried about that song.
Why?
I'm afraid it might bring back stylish stouts.
Yeah, I hope so. Then I won't feel so self-conscious.
Hello, Bing. Hi, Judy.
Well, if it isn't Bill Frawley. Yeah.
Frawley, may I tell you, you're looking nice and shiny and pink tonight.
My pet color, and I feel great.
Yeah?
Say, Bing. Did you see Photoplay magazine this month?
Yes, and I thought it was wonderful.
Wonderful isn't the word for it. There's an ad on page 132 that made a new man of me.
An ad?
Yes, an ad. You know, Judy, for years I've been suffering cold chest misery, and I found relief by the moist heat of antiphlogistine.
Antiphlogistine? Hmm?
Yes, but us satisfied users just call it anti-flow.
Anti-flow. That's cozy.
Now, wait just a minute, Bill. Didn't you see something else in Photoplay?
What else? I applied a poultice of antiphlogistine just hot enough to be comfortable, and it went right to work on that tightness of my chest. Just think of it, Judy. No more muscle soreness.
Oh, well, congratulations, but Bill, didn't you see the cover of Photoplay?
No, I read it in the dentist's office, and the cover was torn off. But anti-flow was in there. And I'll tell you, Bing, since I tried this stuff, I'm singing like a bird.
Well, that reminds me, Bill, you know that you and I haven't beat up a ballad in quite a spell.
Well, the fault is yours. The same old gang is still hanging around the Derby, Bob, Cobb, and all the rest. You never come around and harmonize with us anymore.
Well, I've been pretty tired lately, Bill. I'm shooting the road to Rio with Hope.
Hmm.
He gets me to yawning by noon, and by 6 o'clock, I'm fit for nothing but the feathers.
I don't doubt it, but he'll do it every time.
Anyway, Bill, why don't you and I have a go at one of our old favorites right now?
No? Well, we better go out in the hall and limber up.
Let's play it safe and go out in the alley, huh?
Good.
Oh, wait just a minute. You're not going to leave me here standing with egg on my face.
Oh, yes, Judy, but you have a song in your heart.
Yes. Well, aren't we fortunate that John Scott Trotter has an arrangement of it?
Whatever way we get into song.
Got you under my skin. I tried so not to give in. I said to myself, this affair never will go so well. But why should I try to resist when, darling, I know so well I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats and repeats in my before I begin, 'cause I've got you under my skin. I've got you under my skin. I've got you under my skin. I've got you under my skin.
That was fine, Judy. Did Trotter play all right for you?
Oh, he was great, Bing. How did you and Bill do with your rehearsal last time?
Well, we kicked that all over the alley.
We're going to kick it around right here.
Yeah, well, in that case, I'm going to run to the drugstore. Hey, Bill, what was the name of that stuff for tired muscles?
There's a pail full of it in my dressing room, Judy.
Now, stick around, Judy. Stick around. We'll get to it later.
Sweet as apples are white.
I like to be beside you. I like to be beside you, Ida.
Sweeter than all I know.
Used to know an awful lot, but they ain't got what you've got.
Come out in the silvery moonlight, our love will whisper. So
go soft and low.
If you keep it nice and low, there's no reason folks should know.
Seems all can live without.
Got a certain charm about me, makes it tough to live without me.
Listen, oh honey-do.
Oh cantaloupe, oh honey-do.
I'd advise ya.
Because I love you, I'd indeed I do.
A doodaloo.
Yeah.
Well, that was great, fellas. Gosh, I wonder why girls never get together and sing like men do.
Well, that's mainly, Judy, because they don't hang around the barbershop.
I was just going to ask you, Judy, why don't you drop over to the barbershop some afternoon? Our quartet needs a fifth.
Bring it with you when you come.
Yeah, try and get one of the Walker boys. Yeah. Well, say, by the way, I wonder where Leo McCarey is.
Oh, he'll be along in a minute.
Say, he certainly is a wonderful director. You know, Bells of St. Mary's won the photoplay gold medal.
And incidentally, Judy, you were right up there among the top actresses.
Well, forget about me. Let's talk about McCarey. I think he's a genius.
McCarey is not only a genius, he's not here yet. You know that fellow, though, he doesn't direct you. He hypnotizes you into being good. When he steps on the set with his magnetic voice, you can't help but know that it can only be...
Well, if it isn't Leo McCarey, myself. Hello, Leo, old boy.
I could have sworn that was my line.
Pardon me, I should have attended rehearsal.
Hello, Svengali.
Hello, Trilby.
How you feeling tonight, Influence?
Just fine, theme song.
Hey, Leo, have you seen photoplay this month?
I'll say, and boy, what a thrill. No more tight chest for me. Annie Flo did it again.
I got to get me some of that stuff. My muscles are just twitching for it.
Me too!
And it's also good for simple sprains and bruises. It produces smiles, provokes laughter, strengthens weak bankrolls, helps bad poker hands, steals flat tires, throws zero next... Well, maybe I better pull up. Let's forget about the muscles for a minute, will you? Say, Leo, you know, I've always wanted to find out from you just how good an actor is Bing.
The nicest thing he ever said about me.
Oh, I was just kidding. Of course, Bing's a good actor. I think he's one of the best romantic leads in Hollywood of his generation.
Listen.
Say, Leo, when are you going to direct a picture with Bob Hope in it?
Oh, any day now. I can't stay on top forever. I happen to have here in my pocket a copy of a play that was written by Bob Hope.
A play?
Don't tell me that the author of So This Is Peace has gone a step further and moved drama back to the days when one ape said to the other ape... A funny thing happened to me this afternoon when I was climbing up this tree.
Oh, now, let's not be too hasty, boys. I know Bob, and I'll bet he did nothing but work, work, work on this play.
That's the trouble with it. All work and no play.
Well, I don't see why Hope can't write a play. All it takes is a pencil, paper, and some brains.
Kids loaded with pencils and paper.
So, you know, I got a great idea. How about acting this play out?
How about throwing this play out?
Well, I don't know. I'm not afraid to take a chance on it. I spent most of my life in vaudeville.
Why, Bill, don't tell me you were born on the stage.
Of course not. What could I do for a non-core?
Well, if we're gonna do it, gee whiz, let's get at it. Give me that script, Leo. That's kind of tough to read, isn't it? Wrote it with white ink, huh?
That's toothpaste. That's toothpaste.
Well, go ahead, Leo. Speak up.
I don't like my next line. I pass.
Well, in that case, oh. This looks pretty good, though. They say this isn't bad for Hope. It's about a songwriter. Get this title. The Boarding House Explosion or Rumors Are Flying.
I heard that. I'll try it again. I heard that joke on Hope's program.
I've heard it on everybody's program.
You are gunning.
However, on with the play. Now, Leo, you're the father. Judy, you're the mother. Bill, Frawley, and I are your children, and we have a pet monkey.
Ah, thank goodness there's something around the house with hair on it.
Get out of here. Ladies and gentlemen, as you listen to Mr. McCarey portray the role of a father, please bear in mind that he... Who dropped their wife? Tiffany Blair wants to play a solo yet. Put him on the Hour of Charm. You can't play a solo here. Please bear in mind that as you listen to Mr. McCarey portray the father, I want you to remember that he's been telling me how to act for the last 3 years. Set the scene, John, now. This is the saga of the struggling but talented songwriter who writes tunes exactly like Irving Berlin a month after Berlin has published them. If he's got courage, he won't go out and get a job. He still thinks he can write tunes.
How do you like it so far, Judy?
I'm carried away.
Lucky girl, I'm still here. Curtain, we now take you to the home of Barney Dean, songwriter.
Blue sky smiling after
me.
That's the word I was looking for. Darling, I've done it again. I'm going to write another song as soon as I'm going to write that as soon as I finish Alexander's Ragtime Band.
Oh, Barney, why don't you go out and get a job?
I'll write a hit song or drop dead.
I'll take either one.
Either.
Oh. Listen, do you realize that we're starving? We haven't had any nourishment for weeks.
What do you mean? Isn't old Buttermilk Sky selling?
Yeah, but they're sending all the money to Carmichael and Brooks. I don't care so much for myself, but what about Tom and Jerry?
It's a little early, but I'll join you.
No, I mean Tom and Jerry are children.
Well, you're always complaining about me. Why don't you take care of your housekeeping? There's so much dirt under the rug, I have to walk uphill to get to the piano.
You did before you put that ski lift in.
Well, I want to be lazy. I want to be... Oh, Berlin wrote that too, didn't he?
Here come the children now.
It seems like only yesterday when I wrote Brahms' lullaby for them.
It was only yesterday.
Hello, Mom. Hello,
Hi, Daddy.
Tom and Jerry, look at your curls. Have you been fighting again?
Well, Tom had it coming to him, Mom. He took my doll.
Well, you can get another doll.
Not like this one. She's the classiest dame in town.
It's about time you kids got home. Here comes the old lamplighter down the street. The old lamplighter. I could compose that, too. Make a note of that on one of the children's foreheads.
There's room enough on this forehead for a verse and two choruses. Get a...
No cracks, Mom, please.
Now, Tom, I thought I told you to wash your neck.
I did, Mom.
Then why are your hands so dirty?
From washing my neck.
Well, why didn't you take
Oh, you come in here with me.
Let go of my ear.
Don't you say a word to me now.
Now, quiet, kids, quiet. Daddy's composing.
Well, I'd go and cook dinner if the boys hadn't put that fish up on the weather vane last Friday.
What are you squawking about, Ma? It works fine.
Yeah, now we can tell which way the wind is blowing without looking up.
Will you kids keep quiet? I'm having a lot of trouble with this tune, Tear Bucket Jim.
Tear Bucket Jim. Who wrote that?
Nobody. That's why he's having so much trouble.
Quiet. Quiet. That's it. I've got it. I've done it again.
Did somebody in here write a song called Tear Bucket Jim?
Yes, did you?
No, I represent the J.W. Tear Bucket Company, makers of J.W. Tear Buckets. And we want to buy your tune for our singing commercial.
Hooray! Papa sold a song.
Boy, will this burn up Irving Berlin. He thinks he writes everything.
This will burn up the country. Let's hear a chorus of it right now.
Okay, let's all sing and make it a family affair.
They call him Tear Bucket Jim.
Bucket Jim.
Because everything happens to him.
To him.
The girl of his dreams left him in the lurch.
Some guy picked her up on her way to the church.
Then he quit his work. He wound up just a jerk.
Decided to call it a day.
Then he took to
eyeballs.
And with bloodshot
eyeballs.
his lost fiance.
Fiance.
I haven't eaten in days, and the room rent is due. But never mind about me, dear.
Happy birthday to you.
So if I go any place, people laugh in my face. But never mind about me, dear.
Happy birthday to you.
I think that I'll end it all, dear. And just as a whim,
as a whim,
I'll send you my clothes, because they might fit him.
Might fit him.
So alack and alas, before I turn on the gas, just say hello to your mother.
Hello, Mom.
And happy birthday to you.
Well, I don't think Bob's play was half bad.
You mean it was all bad?
No, about three quarters. I'll take it. Mm-hmm. Hello? Yes? You did? Oh, really? Well, what do you know? That was Daryl Zanuck, and he heard us broadcast Bob's play.
Wonderful. Is he buying the play?
No, he's selling his radio.
Gee, I hope it isn't a Philco.
Well, of course it isn't, Bing. People aren't selling their Philcos. They're buying more of them. No kidding, either. Most every family can use a second radio around the house. For instance, if you've already got a Philco table model, maybe you'd also like a radio phonograph so you can play records. In that case, you can't miss with the Philco 1201, the easiest way to play records ever invented. Just slide a record in, and the 1201 does the rest automatically. And don't forget, the 1201 gives you a powerful radio, too. Or if you're all fixed for a radio phonograph, you can certainly use that sensational new Philco Portable. It's actually two radios in one. A home radio you can plug into the house current, and a handy, lightweight portable that plays on its own long-life batteries when you're traveling. A real powerhouse gets you stations that are hard to tune in, even on big sets. And it's a Philco. Famous for quality the world over.
Right in through here seems like a dandy place for some shut-eye in D-flat. Skitch Henderson is going to join me.
The moon descends, and so to bed. The music ends, and so to bed. Should old acquaintance linger in your heart, then don't forget we're just a dream apart. Tomorrow night seems years away, but after all, it's just today. And I remember every word you said. I miss you so, and so to bed. And so to you.
should do it for tonight, and I want to thank Judy Garland, Bill Frawley, and Leo McCarey for coming over. And that really was Leo's song, so all complaints should be sent directly to him.
Well, I can take it.
Good night. I'll say, Judy, what studio are you with now?
MGM, producers of Until the Clouds Roll By.
Oh, that's the group out in Culver City.
That's right.
Yes, nice. Good night, folks.
Good
thank
night,
you. Good night, Bill.
Good night, Tom.
Tom.
This program was produced and transcribed in Hollywood by Bill Morrow and Murdo McKenzie. Tune in to Philco Radio Time next week and hear Bing Crosby, John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, the Charioteers, Skitch Henderson, and Peggy Lee. And remember, only Philco makes the 1201. It's the newest invention in radio from Philco, the leader.